cards up and higher, you bet. The next card's a four. You'll take it, no sweat, on Card Shark. And here's the host of Card Shark, Jim Perry.
Thank you, Lewis. Hi, thank you. Welcome to Card Shark. Thank you. You're very kind. Thank you. See, I hope you've been with us for this entire turnabout tournament where we've taken some of the top MCs and they're playing for their favorite charities. I've gotten so excited. Notice he gave me a bigger microphone today because I almost strained my throat with the last show yesterday. It was very exciting. We'll get back to business in a moment. First, I want to thank for the opening poem Heather Dewey of Weeford, Ontario, Canada, watching on WGR-TV, Channel 2. Now, I got to tell you this before we open the board. We're starting to open the board. I'll tell you. Go ahead. Lois and Melinda start loading in the cars, and I will tell you that in this very exciting championship, we are down to one fellow who's doing extremely well. Jack Clark's got a good bit of money, so he'll be back next week, I would think, for sure, for the finals. Very close right now between Alex Trebek and Jim Lang. It's their turn to play. Let's bring them out right now. You're close. What is this with the cards?
I brought my own cards.
Oh, yeah? Yeah.
Better change.
What's it say?
Okay, for those of you who have wondered why NBC's ratings in recent weeks have gone down, this is a line from one of their nighttime shows.
Uh-huh.
Another thing, there's too many women in politics. England has a prime minister who's abroad. Sheesh, no wonder they got that leaning tower over there. Okay, does that tell you something?
That was a strong show there, yeah.
Oh, you can get another one over here. We got better. Oh, no, you don't want to see those.
Very exciting, really, because I remember last week we wound up with Bill Cullen and who else is coming back? Gene Rayburn.
We don't
back
care about
next
that.
Week.
Let's get our match
Two
going.
Of these four very good players are coming back. Alex, $2,850.
Hey, I saw Gene Rayburn. He's not that good.
Well, right now, you're in good shape. Jim Lang is not that far behind. No. $1,600.
Yeah.
This match
He's
could
tough.
Decide it.
He's tough.
Who are you playing for?
Oh, the charity.
Yes.
You ask such tough questions. I'm playing for the ICANN Associates.
All right.
Interagency. Yeah. See, a lot of people don't know what that is. Interagency Council for Child Abuse and Neglect.
A good charity. So Jim, how about you?
The National Association for the Visually Handicapped.
All right. Let's get to business. Best two out of three. Good luck. Starting with a question, Alex.
Can't see the cards.
Alex, we asked 100 married men. Very simply, is your wife a nag? How many married men said, yeah, their wife is a nag?
42.
You're not going to get yourself in trouble with this one, right?
42 of those guys said that.
42 out of 100. What do you say, higher or lower, Jim?
Well, it doesn't have to be a nag all the time, just sometimes nagging. I would say higher.
Higher than higher. That? Mm-hmm. If it's higher, you'll play your cards. If not, Alex plays his. The actual number of married men who said that their wife is a nag is 31. Not higher, it's lower. Alex gets it.
Well,
Alex starts off the match with a six.
Change that.
Meaning the question,
please.
You can change it? Ooh. Yeah, tough card with a seven.
Lois, I'm going to meet you in the parking lot afterwards and break off both your legs at the knees. Higher.
Higher than a seven.
Yes, an eight.
Now what?
I'm going to play chicken and go freeze.
Freezing on that middle card? That's not bad. It keeps Jim away from his cards. Maybe a good play. Jim, we asked 100 married women.
Mm-hmm.
If a wife does not want to have children, but her husband does, is it okay for her to take birth control pills without telling him?
Ooh.
How many married women said, yeah, it's okay for a wife to take birth control pills without telling
her
husband?
That's a tough question. I think they should talk it over, frankly, but some of the women, 32.
32 out of 100 say, it's okay. Take the pill. Don't tell him.
You know,
higher.
Woman's yelling higher and all the men are yelling lower.
Yeah.
I think...
He said 32.
Gosh, now we're getting into the nitty-gritty of family life, and I think that's such an important subject. You shouldn't keep secrets, and I'll have to go lower.
You say lower?
Yeah.
A lot of agreement from the audience.
I'm trying to preserve the family. I don't care about the survey.
The actual number of married women who said it's okay for a wife to take birth control pills without telling her husband is 37, not lower. Jim has it by five.
I don't want to know those women.
Oh,
at this time, it's Jim Lang.
All right, a three. Oh. I like that. I'll play with that. They run the board. Higher.
Higher than a three.
That happened to me.
Alex, with an eight, you're up the middle and a free call.
Free call. Gonna go lower.
Lower than an eight.
No, a nine. It's not lower. Wait a minute. I got a straight forming. 7, 8, and 9.
That's another show.
I'll see your 100 and raise you.
Wrong
question
show.
Question goes to you, Alex.
Oh, sorry.
Alex, we asked 100 people. Have you ever gotten a real deal on something from a relative, only to discover you could have gotten it a lot cheaper from a total stranger?
No, I never have.
How many people said, yeah, they've gotten stung by a relative?
I don't think that would happen all that often. I think that looks good in print and in television series. Somebody just yelled out 16. That's not bad. You're pretty close. I'll say 32.
32.
32.
32
out of 100.
Hey, I doubled his stung by a relative.
That was really close.
I thought so.
A lower.
It's all relative.
I think it's even lower than
that. I
think
the relatives do look out for them.
They're taking care of their own, sure.
The actual number of people who got stung by a relative is 25. Jim,
it is lower.
Lucked out by 7.
Jim, you got a great card of 3.
Those were my 7 cousins.
Listen to the audience. All right, higher.
Higher than a 3. Yes, a jack.
All right.
You going to run it?
Lower.
Lower than a jack. A 4.
All right. Higher.
Higher than a 4. A 6.
Oh. All right. I'm going to go. This is it.
No.
Higher.
Is it higher for the game? No. Back to the base card goes Jim. Alex a break and again a free chance.
Greedy, greedy, greedy.
All right.
Oh, I got a chance.
Yeah.
Well, the card she turned over a while ago was a 9. Is it the same card?
I don't know. It's been moved. And don't know. We got the next
She put
card
another one there?
She put a Nova from your deck.
I said lower before, and it was higher. I'll say lower again.
Is it lower? This time it is with a 7.
Frise.
That's a pretty good freeze, because with Alex needing 2 cards, as we fill in the spaces for Jimmy, needs 4, sudden death. Someone's going to have to win it right here.
Sudden death?
Sudden death.
Oh, yeah.
I made the right move by error.
Yes.
It was that my question?
No, it's Jim's question.
Oh, okay. Sure.
Jim, our man on the street, went to a nudist camp in Southern California.
He did. Who's
where he
man?
Asked 100 men, do you subscribe to Playboy magazine? How many men nudists do subscribe to Playboy?
Now you've got a real decision to make there. Are they too far beyond Playboy if they're in a nudist camp, or are they...
That's the question.
Yeah, I know.
The question is, do they need it?
That's right. Good thinking. Thank you.
Thank you. You're welcome. Give a number.
I'd say 40 of the 100.
40 out of 100 do subscribe to Playboy.
I'm going to need your help.
What do you think?
They're saying vote for Reagan. You said 40?
40, yeah. How many subscribe to Playboy?
Nudist. I think the people in a nudist colony are more... Going to be lower.
Lower.
Going to be lower.
The actual number of men nudists who subscribe to Playboy
magazine. Don't say I'm probably right, because now I'm
26.
Worried.
26, it's lower. Alex has it. Alex, you've got control and sudden death. You have a 7. You could change it and try to turn over 2 cards. Jim has a 3. He needs 4 cards. You've got control. Play or pass?
I have watched this game this week. I have seen James Lang go right through the whole board.
He has done it.
But I don't think he can do it now, so I'm going to pass.
You're going to pass it? Got to get them all, Jim. What do you say with a 3, Jim?
All right, here we go. Higher?
Higher than a 3. Yes, a 4.
Higher.
Higher than a 4. A king.
All right. Yeah, lower.
Lower. A 5. All and right. Now the big call.
This is for the game. Higher.
Is
come on.
Higher? Oh, Alex wins it. His sudden death. Game 1 going to Alex Trebek. We'll be right back as Jim Lang tries to make a comeback after this.
Get ready to match the star.
Match game. Face swapping before swapping faces was cool. Tonight at 2 on Buzzer.
Hey, you guys get me excited. I hope my throat's going to make it through the rest of the week.
I hope so too, Jim.
Game 1, Alex Trebek. Same 2 decks of cards. Next card's off the top of the deck. And now Jim Lang needs a game. Question you, Alex.
Oh.
Alex, we surveyed 100 married women in London, England.
I want to meet the guy who did all these surveys for you.
Isn't
in London.
Isn't that terrific?
He had a
travel
fantastic
all over the
holiday.
Place. Yeah. London, England, married women. We asked them, have you ever telephoned a pub looking for your husband? How many English married women have phoned a pub looking for hubby?
Well, I follow that cartoon strip, Andy Cat.
Hell yeah.
She goes down to the pub to get him. I think that a fair number of the women probably call the pub. Let's go with about... No, not 60. I'm going to go a little lower than that. 47.
47 out of 100.
47,
call the pub
okay.
Looking for hubby.
I think in England, the pubs are such a social thing. They know the husband is there, but they might have to call him occasionally for, you know, really personal reasons. But I still say lower.
Lower than that?
Lower.
Okay.
Lower.
The actual number of English married women who have phoned a pub looking for their husband is
49. Not lower by two, Alex has it.
I was going to say 49.
You said enough to win it, and Alex starts with an 8.
Change that.
Getting rid of the middle card. 10 a little better.
Well, I've got nothing to lose. Let's go lower.
Lower than a 10. Yes, a 3.
Let's go higher.
Higher than a 3. A king.
Let's go lower.
Risking it lower. A 10.
Freeze.
He didn't want to go all the way back to the base card.
First time.
Question to you, Jim.
All right.
Quicksand time.
Jim, we asked 100 men who have been married for 50 years or more.
Old timers.
Now, we know it's not polite to kiss and tell, but you can tell us.
Mm-hmm.
Did you and your wife become lovers before you were married?
Mm-hmm.
How many men married 50 years said yeah?
Now, we're going back to 1930.
Uh-huh.
Married.
Hey, you had well.
I know. I figured that out. Unless this is a rerun, and then it's more.
Hurry. We got it.
How many
18
became?
18 out of 100 married 50 years or more became lovers before the wedding. What do you think?
Well, I know it was another era, but the automobile had just been invented. Gotta be higher.
And with it, the rumble.
That's all I'm saying.
With it, the rumble seat and everything else. 18 and higher.
I didn't expand on it. Why do you?
Well, it was a visual image.
Of course.
The actual number of men married 50 years who said they were lovers before marriage is 37. You're right, Alex. It is higher.
Oh, yeah.
Alex,
changed
great
the
position. 10. And a very big change for Alex, needing one card for a crack at the money. A 4.
Here we go.
Come on, 5, Ken. Let's go higher.
Is it higher?
Yes.
Hey.
Alex Trebek wins it.
Good job.
Jim, 1,600 so far.
Thank you.
I mean, we'll have time for another match. We'll see you in a little while.
So. Good luck.
Alex right. Trebek goes for the big money for his charity right after this commercial break. Did you get over here and away from Lois and Melinda here?
Sure.
Did you cut this money, guys?
Hi, guy. Yes, I did.
Let's get over and get the business. Oh, okay. Hop on up here. Already over the $3,000 mark for your favorite charity. Let's see if we can add to it right now. And here we go. $200. You know how to do it. 3 cards. $200 on the second level. Another 3. Total of $28,800 is possible right now if you can go double, double, double all the way up.
I can do it.
All right. Here we go.
Unfortunately, I probably won't.
Let's go ahead. Let's get a big chunk.
Give me a good opener.
Here's $200.
Come on.
Do remember, you can change that base card if we don't get you a good opener.
It's going to be a good one. It's going to
we'll
be a
start.
2.
Oh, an ace. That's the nice. Don't fall off the podium.
Gonna go. They're only. Yeah. But if I do all of it. Okay, all of it higher. I mean lower. What am I doing?
$200 the whole thing. Lower than an ace. Yes, with a 7 at 400.
Okay, I've got $400. I'm gonna bet $50 higher.
Minimum bet $50 higher. You bet it right. You got a better card with 350 and a 3.
350. 300. Higher.
$300. Higher than a 3. Yes, with a king. Way to go.
Is that a king or a jack?
That is a king. As we move it up,
see,
we get the
Canada,
other 200.
We're behind. We don't know these things.
$850 and a king.
$800 lower.
$800 lower than a king. Yes, with a 10. $1,650.
$250 lower.
$250 lower than a 10. He's right again with another 3 at $1,900.
$1,600 higher.
$1,600 higher than a 3.
Moving again.
Oh, you're right. Oh, I got nervous.
Change to 5.
3,500. Do you want that 5?
Change it.
A big change because you've got great money for the big bet. And a 2. 3,500 and a 2. Just 3 more 2s. That's all that can hurt you.
Fat Sam is going for the whole bundle.
Going higher, of course. $3,500. That means $7,000 for Alex's favorite charity if this card is higher. Yes! Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Nicely done. Nicely done.
Mississippi Gambler. Rise again.
Mississippi Gambler. $10,050. for the Interagency Council for Child Abuse and Neglect.
No, that's in the pocket for the charity. Even if I put it in my pocket.
It ain't going in your pocket. It's going to the charity. We'll be right back right after this. We are back, and we're coming towards the end of this second week with the Round Robin playing Turnabout with fine MCs, and the two highest scorers so far this week, and the way that's going to finish up, they'll be coming back for the finals against Bill Cullen and Gene Rayburn, are Alex Trebek and Jack Clark, both of whom had very good money. Two very good players. We've got some time. They're back to make a little more money for their favorite charity. Let's welcome back Jim Lang and Tom Kennedy.
Thank you, Jim.
We don't have a lot of time, gentlemen, so we have set up. We're going to set up for a tiebreaker. Whoever wins the tiebreaker goes immediately over and plays the money cards for another crack at some money for their favorite charity. You're two nice gentlemen. Let's get to it.
Let's make some money for those kids.
Here we go. Jim, we asked 100 married men, did you meet your wife on a blind date?
Mm-hmm.
How many men said, yeah, they did meet their wife on a blind date?
39 out of 100.
39 out of 100?
That's right there.
Yeah.
That's it.
He's confident.
Lower, fewer.
Fewer than that.
Oh, I think so, yes.
See how quickly they made that decision. The actual number of married men who did meet their wife on a blind date is 23. Tom is right. Oh, it is lower. Go Tom gets that all important first
this
part.
This is it.
A Jack.
All right. That's not too bad. I'll go lower.
Lower than a Jack.
Yes. No.
And Jim Lang gets a free chance at a six.
Higher.
Higher than a six. A queen.
Lower.
For a crack at the money. No. And ace comes up.
No, all right.
We'll fill in the spaces and the question to Tom.
This is exciting.
Tom, we asked 100 millionaires, do you worry about money? How many millionaires said, yeah, they worry about money?
Huh. That's interesting, huh?
How many?
Well, believe it or not, I think that millionaires do worry about money. I would say 67.
67 out of 100.
I think millionaires probably worry about money more than anybody else because that's how they got $1 million. I'll say higher.
Higher than that.
Hmm.
The actual number of millionaires who worry about money is 54. Not higher, it's lower. And Tom again gets that first crack, and you're looking at a Jack.
I guess I better stay with that Jack. I have the option of changing that.
You can indeed if you'd like to.
No, I'm going to stay with it. Now we'll go lower.
Lower than a Jack.
Yes,
a 9.
All right. All right. Lower.
Lower for the win. No, it's not lower. Jim Lang with a free chance to call up the 6.
Higher.
Higher, he says. A 2 is not higher. We are down to sudden death in the tiebreaker. Let's get to it quickly. So let's just have the answer and the higher or lower. Jim, we asked 100 doctors' wives, did your telephone ring after midnight last night?
Hmm.
How many doctors' wives said, yeah, the telephone rang after midnight last night?
38.
38.
Oh, higher.
Higher than that. The actual number of doctors' wives whose telephone did ring after midnight last night is 26. Not higher, it's lower. Jim, you've got an option. You can play it or pass it.
All right. I can pass, huh?
You want to pass it or play it?
I'll play it. What the heck?
You want to play it with the 6 or change it?
Change the 6.
And it's a big change, changing that 6. Oh, an 8.
Lower.
Lower, he says. It's not lower. Tom wins it in sudden death. Jim, we'll see you in a moment. We bring everybody back. Let's quickly move things around. Tom, come on down here with me. We're running out of time. We're going to roll the machinery around. I know you cut those cards for the money cards. So let's get everything moving, and let's get to it right now. Come on over here with the podii. Tom Kennedy very quickly going for the Cerebral Palsy School of Louisville, Kentucky.
That's right.
Here we go. Let's turn it around and get to it there. I know we're running out of time, so let's do it as quickly as we possibly can. Come on, podium. Get over here. Start dealing them out, Lois and Melinda. We know. We know how to do it. Here come the cards. And we're going to start you off with $200. Oh, yes. Everything is ready. We're going to start you off with $200, and come on. Let's see if we can get some good cards for Tom and his favorite charity.
Give me a good start.
Thank you, Melinda. You've got a 10. Do you want it?
No, I don't. Change it.
Changing the 10.
Yeah.
To a 3.
That's good. Higher. I have to tell you the bet. No. I have 200, 100 higher.
100 higher. It is 100. 100. Yeah. You've got it for
$50. 50 higher.
150 higher. No. Down to 250 and a good car.
250. 100 higher.
$100 higher. He's right for the king. 350. We move up the king and give you the other 200. 550.
All right. I've got 550.
550.
200 lower.
200 lower than a king. No. 350 is still a good card.
200 lower.
Come on, let's be there. Lower.
200.
That's a 2 for 550.
400
Higher.
400 higher than a 2. Yes, with a 10.
950, do you want that 10?
No, change it.
Big change.
I want a change.
A jack.
Good. 475. The whole thing lower.
He's going to go for all of it.
950 lower.
Be there. Lower. No. Well, listen, you busted on it, but there's no way that people like you and like Jim who have worked so hard are going to go away empty-handed. For your charity and for Jim's, you're under that amount, $5,000 for each of your...
Absolutely. Fantastic.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
We'll be right back, right after this. We are back with four terrific guys who have done a great job for their favorite charities, and we're delighted. Alex Trebek and Jack Clark, you're going to come back on Monday, along with Bill Cullen and with Gene Rayburn in the finals. We have to say goodbye. Jim Lang, thank you so much. $5,000 for
the National Aid Division Handicapped. They had a great time. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you. And another $5,000 for you, Tom.
Cerebral Palsy is doing Louisville, Kentucky.
Thank you, guys. Have a nice weekend. See you in the finals on Monday. Bye-bye.
Some members of the studio audience will receive BedSac. New idea in bed covering provides luxury upholstery for your old mattress or box springs and protection for new furnished by BedSac. A cheese board and flavor in Gino's Party Special Pizza with a crisp and tasty crust you can trust, plus the flavor shaker Gino's in your grocer's freezer. A garden set, Knox unflavored gelatin, makes houseplants fuller and greener. Look for instructions on specially marked boxes of Knox's unflavored gelatin. A carrying case in skincare and cosmetics from Fashion 220. Free beauty consultation in the privacy of your home. Fashion 220 for a lovely way of life. Tired of paper plates that fold up, china holds up. They're specially made for special occasions. Get super strong china when quality counts. A bathroom scale and new Renewzit adjustable air freshener. It lasts 25% longer. Open it a little or a lot. It all depends on the odors you've got. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Welcome to the first...